I mean, the underdogs, right? They've always been seen as the underdogs, especially within the last sort of 6-7 years. So it gives you a great example how the underdogs can be successful, and not to sort of think that they're not going to make it. So yeah, I think it's been fantastic that they won the FA Cup against such a great Premier League team. And yeah, definitely has impacted me in my coaching to not underestimate the underdogs. Yeah, I think, you know, we've definitely got a lot of strength within our side. Like with any side, there's areas to improve on, which is what we're working on at the moment, so that we can go full speed when we turn up to Rwanda. But definitely not to ignore the strengths that we have. A lot of other teams need to be aware of the strengths that we have, for sure. It's going to be a long-term process, for sure. You know, we're going to be looking at success and trying to make sure that, you know, what does success look like? Whether that means we're winning games, or whether that means that when we come out of these sort of three tournaments that we got coming up, having a sort of high performance program, that sort of stuff. For me, it's a long-term process. Every team needs to fail. Every team needs to fail to become successful. You know, that's the only way you're going to know where you're going to, what areas you need to improve on. So failure is definitely something which is needed in any format, in any sport, in any game, because that's the only way that you're going to become successful and be the top at your game. I've got a... I mean, playing wise, it probably has to be the great Sachin Tendulkar. But my favourite all-rounder, you'll have to ask my wife, she knows all the answers to these questions, has to be Sir Garfield Sobers. I think he's a pinnacle of the cricketer.